Yes, students, welcome back to physics class. Today we are going to deal with a new chapter, force and laws of motion. So you are not unfamiliar with force. You studied in 8th standard force and pressure. In that chapter you studied classification of force, contact force and non-contact force, and contact force or muscular force and frictional force, non-contact force, gravitational force, electrostatic force, magnetic force, etc. But this chapter we are going to view in a different way. That is, force is divided into two. That is another classification: balanced force and unbalanced force. Balanced force means the object continue in the state of rest or motion unless until we are giving whatever the force we are giving to that object. So a good example I will say about the earth. You know, the earth is rotating and it is moving in a same speed. It is in uniform motion. It will not change its speed. But its velocity is changing as its direction is changing at it at every instant. As whatever the force, gravitational force or any other force, it's there. Earth will not change its speed. And that force is known as balanced force. Okay. So the object continue in the state of rest or motion. If or whatever the object, in the case of the tug of war, I will say, in the case of the rest, the two teams are applying the same force on both sides of the rope remains in the rest itself. It means balanced force. The force applying is, all the force are applying is balanced there. That is, continue in the state of rest or motion, it's whatever the force is applying. So it is known as balanced force. Once more I will say, whatever the force we are applying to an object, object remains its state itself. If it is in rest, it continue in the rest itself. If it is in motion, it continue in the motion itself. And this is known as balanced force. And the next one is unbalanced force. The word itself you can feel uncomfortable. That is, it's unbalanced. Something is there. So many points are there in below the unbalanced force. By applying an unbalanced force, if the object is in rest, it can we can change to motion. If the object is in motion, we can increase its speed or decrease its speed or change its direction by applying an unbalanced force. Also, we can change the shape of the object. So whatever the force we are giving, the object will take the side of the larger force. So if two persons are pulling on object, pulling or pushing from both sides, the object will take the side of the larger force is applying. That it move in the direction of the larger force applied, and that force is known as unbalanced force. So based on this balanced force and unbalanced force, Newton, you know Isaac Newton, he's a well-known physicist. And he made a law based on that, and is known as Newton's first law of motion. It states that an object remains in a state of rest or of uniform motion. If an object is in rest or in uniform motion, in a straight line. So the one condition is that it should be in a straight line. If it is in uniform motion, it should take the straight line itself unless compelled to change that state by an applied force. So unless we are applying an unbalanced force there, the object will continue in the state of rest or uniform motion in a straight line. So this applied force is also known as unbalanced force. So if the object continue in the state of rest or uniform motion in a straight line unless it is compelled to change by that state by an applied force. So this is known as Newton's first law. It's very simple law. And we can learn something more about Newton's first law and motion and inertia of motion in the next class. Thank you all of you.